So now it's time to put all of our building blocks together, and we're just this close to showing that SAT is indeed NP complete. So we started out with a problem in NP and an input for that problem. Of course, this here can be any problem in NP, and this here can be any input for that problem. And what did we then do? We said if the problem is in NP, then there must be some algorithm for that problem, which runs in polynomial time on a non-deterministic RAM. So an algorithm or a program, you can call it any way you want. So that will run in polynomial time. And the algorithm at some lines of the code either says yes or it says no, but it's running in polynomial time in any case. And of course the input for the problem, well, that is basically just the number of variables in the memory of the machine as it starts out. And then we took all this, and of course it's a huge Boolean formula and you would probably never really want to write it out explicitly, but it exists and it contains a number of components that we have discussed. So one part of the Boolean formula encodes snapshots of the algorithm as it runs on the machine. Then we said we have to have one part that ensures that the first snapshots properly represents the starting conditions, so that it properly represents the algorithm starting at line one and also the memory representing the input for the problem. Then what we just discussed is that through a number of rules that look like if-then, you can ensure that the snapshots at a certain point in time t and at the following time point fit together. And then finally, since this here is a decision problem, we want to ensure that the Boolean formula can only be satisfied if at a certain point in time the algorithm returns yes. So this is the last part we have to add to the Boolean formula. And this is actually quite easy to ensure because once the algorithm reaches this line of the code, wherever it may be, and you can even have multiple lines where the algorithm returns yes, but once such a line has been reached, the algorithm returns yes and stops. So this here is very easy to ensure. You just have to make sure that there's one snapshot where the algorithm is in a line that returns a yes. So once we have constructed this Boolean formula, what happens if we solve SAT for this formula? Then there's two cases that can happen because SAT is also a decision problem. So either SAT returns yes or it returns no. What if it returns yes? If it returns yes, that means that there is a satisfying assignment for this Boolean formula. And a satisfying assignment will have the following property. First of all, it will encode valid snapshots of where the algorithm is and what's in the memory. Secondly, it will also ensure that the machine starts out in the right place, meaning it starts out at line one of the code and representing the input for the problem. It will ensure that all of the snapshots that it has figured out will fit together, and it can only return yes if the algorithm returns yes at some point in time. So if we have a yes here, we also know that this problem, or the decision problem here, is one where a non-deterministic RAM would also answer yes. If it says no, on the other hand, what does that mean? Well, we know that we always can encode the snapshots. So it's not going to say no because it cannot encode a snapshot, because that's possible always. It also won't say no due to this property here, because, well, we have ensured that the snapshot can be properly encoded. So there's no mistake in the formula here. So it cannot say no because of this here. It also cannot say no because of this here, because the machine will always run and you can make the snapshots fit together. The only reason why there can be no, why there could be no satisfying assignment is if the algorithm does not return yes at a certain point in time. And since this algorithm solves this problem here, if it cannot reach yes, then this means that this decision problem here is also a no. So satisfiability only if this problem, given this input here, is a yes. So now that we have put it all together, here's our final quiz for proving that SAT is NP complete. And what I would like you to do is to recap the properties of this Boolean formula here. First of all, what's the size of this Boolean formula? For an input of size n, and remember this algorithm here runs in polynomial time. So is this Boolean formula up here constant in size, polynomial in size, or exponential in size with respect to n? And then can this Boolean formula encode any algorithm, at least for a problem that is in NP? Can it encode any input of size n that we're given to that problem? And finally, is this Boolean formula only satisfiable if the input here is a yes to that decision problem here? Or are there any other cases where we could also have satisfiability? So please check all of these that are true.